mean you don't like me, you wanna fight me. Always on my page, never double tap like me. Baddies to my left and my right. Never chase a corny nigga, put that on my life.
Seems to be completely random.
Oh, shit. Let's pray for me.
Right.
It's a whole day at the break for this guy. But the reason most people, or at least most females, most female and female trans women, get what you call logs, or do something called dysphoria. And that's a term that refers to
The penis.
Yeah, the negative, all the negative psychological trauma really that comes with having the body. The sex that your mind is not. But I'm very lucky actually, because psychologically I don't have that for certain parts of my body. But other parts like my shoulder, I have a really strong ligament for the strong jawline that testosterone gave me. I really want to have facial feminization surgery one day.
To me, I mean, honestly, I'll show you some of my friends back in high school. Like, I won't out her because we're not friends anymore, but you look just like her, and I'll show you pictures. And she was the most beautiful girl always. I mean, very 70s look. Like, you have a very 70s look, me, with the hair.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah. So, I don't know what you're talking about, feminization of your jawline. You have a nice jawline.
I know, I agree.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's like jawline, brow.
Listen, if I didn't know off rip of what the situation was when I came in, sorry if it's wonky. I didn't know, and when we greeted each other, I would have had to maybe ask, and it would have just been up. You just not wear a lot of makeup? Like, some women are shy. Some women don't always come out as in, lashes, and me and Mistress wear makeup. But, you have that look, and it's a very natural look. Like, I would have never, you would have had to tell me, I would have had to ask.
Yeah.
And I would have been like, sorry,
Okay,
what do you got?
I've never worn falsies.
I love it. I think you're amazingly
gorgeous. We share makeup.
Yeah, right.
Oh my gosh, so is it?
Are you close
enough? We share clothes too.
Listen, not even just this is a thing going on to you. My sister do that too. Today she was patting my face real hard with ice and stuff, and she's like, did she thought we're the same? She's like, how the hell am I supposed to do your makeup? She's like, I don't know what people think of your face, but like mine. Because I look like I'm in a mirror, and
I can't tell that.
So, and same with clothes. I mean, now that she's got her BBL, my butt matches hers exactly. She's jealous. She was standing. She's like, bitch, why is your slippery? And I'm like, well, you have
to pay. Yeah.
I am just very much into what is going on. Like, I love this dynamic. I think you guys are amazing, beautiful music. You guys look like you. It looks like not only just in work, but together.
We're actually doing a ceremony, a call-in ceremony for her birthday this year. Pretty much celebrating like her birthday and like our year anniversary. And then
birthday or second rebirth?
Actual birthday.
Do you have a second birthday?
I would say it was probably.
Oh, that's interesting. That's hilarious.
So wait, tell us. Okay, so parents don't know. What happens when you? Have you not been home in 6 months? You're not that.
I keep asking the same fucking question.
Okay,
just came back from visiting my parents.
Yeah, I'm like, how did they not notice?
What happened?
Well, I
beef can't get up to go home.
No, I mean, I've never been like the most masculine man when I went there.
But I mean, did you like tie your hair off when you went home?
Like, no, I've had long hair all my life and I just wore it down. So
you always were rocking. But did they say, where's your
penis? So I was actually still living at home with my parents when I. That's a long story.
Yeah.
with that. while me and Mrs. Rose were communicating in the. And that's when I shaved my beard, and they were like, you look so much better with a beard. I can't wait for you to grow it back.
Oh my god!
When I went home like last week,
the beard.
Oh, they did?
Did you put your hair on a ponytail?
I didn't usually wear a ponytail.
Like a ponytail?
Hooray!
hurting my throat.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, I was gonna say. But then I can barely do mine. So don't worry. It's done.
What about, okay, clothes wise? Do you wear a collar to go home?
Absolutely. Okay, you allow her to make it.
Yeah, so there's rules about the collar.
Is that where you put your butt down? You're like, listen.
Yeah, so she wears her collar everywhere. But family and work, if necessary. Yeah.
Now, when you went home, you know, is this a more Catholic Christian home? Like, is that
what is like?
Okay. So at home. I just have to know. Like, do you have brothers and sisters?
I have sisters.
Okay, she obviously has sisters. Always your brother.
Yeah. Before you come.
Oh, my sister wants to pop those tits.
All right. Tits.
did you get pregnant with this, bro?
He did it.
Oh my god.
This is the one you got to be pregnant with.
Jesus Christ. Three straps, five hooks.
You bought me this, bro.
Oh, I did? Oh. Tried to keep you safe.
That's hilarious.
Sorry. Okay, so back to the store. So, okay, they made. Well, do you think it's ignorance?
Absolutely, 100%.
Yeah, it's just ignorance because they're
has
not.
Has to be.
Like, yeah. Just because they don't know anybody, right? There's nobody.
Exactly.
Like, did your grandma decide to turn? Like, no, right? So there's no, like, family.
No, they don't know anybody that anybody that they know.
That they know. Did your sister say, like, when did she ask you questions? What are you going to come out? What are you going to say?
She didn't ask me anything. She just let it be and just let me. As well as I could.
I mean, like I said, I thought this was something like years in making. I did not know that you were
super.
You're like a
new. A lot has happened.
Is that the giving say?
Oh, in many ways, it's beautiful.
You're still in the tit.
No, I wasn't really into. Well, I was into BDSM and kink. Personally, you know, that was what always turned me on.
Okay, so this is my second dungeon. My first dungeon.
Since we started where you flew to America.
Yeah. Oh, Oh, yeah, I did all sorts of stuff. Okay, first of all, I went to school for graphic design. So I'm a graphic designer and I'm a photographer. Yeah, so that's what I did for like 9 years. And then, you know.
Did I need help on my website?
Always.
I'm asking you right now.
I've always been very interested into the lifestyle to a point that I just couldn't help being into the community so hardcore, you know? And one thing that led to another, you know, I don't need to do the story here.
Hey, it's not all makes sense. Listen, we'll just edit out whatever we don't want.
Yeah. So technically, I was going through my second divorce.
Wait, we're going to back up. Were you married overseas too?
No, I got married here.
White guy?
No, it was a Venezuelan guy, actually.
You found one here?
No, the guy I came with.
Oh, okay, you guys got married.
Yeah, we were very young. I got married at like, 21 or something?
That didn't last.
Yeah, that didn't because obviously
I...
Yeah, nice cock.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't think so small cock.
Like, I'm divorcing you and I want it bigger.
Yeah. If you're gonna be cock in my life, it's gonna be big. But anyway, that's not beyond the point. Unimportant. So, got married, got divorced. He left to Chile. He's having a great life. It wasn't for him.
Yeah.
You know?
Of course.
Then my second husband kind of got me into... Okay, so let's talk about how when I was in my country, Venezuela, I thought that this lifestyle was just only something that you watched on porn or in movies, you know. I never thought it was actually a lifestyle that you could live in and be happy and be actually functional and all that crap, you know. So I found a little bit of the community. I was living back in Miami in 2015, 2014, and I got married to this guy. We kind of started having like a DS relationship, but it was really like dominant submissive.
Okay.
Yeah. So he had no idea what the fuck he was doing. I had no idea what the fuck I was
so
doing.
So you guys are just like...
We had no idea what the fuck was going on.
Like DS for dummies.
Yeah, pretty much. So it went down pretty fast, and fortunately we broke up because, you know, there was like a lot of cheating involved.
Because he didn't understand.
Unethical stuff, you know, lots of miscommunication. So I moved up here to Tampa, and actually, no, wait, hold on, I'm skipping. So while I was going through my divorce, I went on FetLife, which is like a fucking incredible website for the
FET?
FetLife,
F-E-T. FetLife,
yeah, pretty much. It's like a Facebook for kinky people.
I
need to be on there.
Yeah, you can look me up, Mistress. Like, oh, I'm sorry. I was gonna make my own page.
Yes, I wanna look up Mistress. It's like you have like a profile, like just like Facebook. So I went there and I start going for like, you know, crazy stuff, just like kind of exploring lots of crazy stuff. You know, at that point, I was like, what is this? Like, what am I looking at? You know,
I've never heard of that.
Oh my God, people do this and it's local.
Yeah.
So I found somebody there, and I met them, and they took me to my first sex party.
Oh, I've been to those.
Girl, I was like,
you know, my favorite,
what the fuck is going on here, and why is this real?
Why is it, you know, my favorite, when you walk in, there's porn on, and whatever's going on before you're doing it, and I'm like, why is that donkey here? That might have been just where I was at.
I go and walk into this place, and it's like a huge house with like a lot of beautiful people playing with each other, and I'm just like, okay, I wanted this in my life.
Yeah.
So actually, the guy's girlfriend is my mentor.
Oh.
We became friends, and I was kind of, you know, playing with her boyfriend at the time because they were poly and all that stuff.
With his
just fucking, you know.
Oh, that's not fun. That's not playing. The game is over.
There's a lot of, you know,
like playing. I love it.
Involved. Would you say play?
You're like sweet now.
Just play.
I'm like, no, bitch, that's going in.
So, she became my mentor, and I saw that she was doing dominatrix work. Her name
she taught you, like, yo, go ahead.
Yeah, Mistress Mercy.
So she taught you. She taught you the law. She taught you the rules.
She was doing it, and I was just continue to do my vanilla job, and I would go to the parties, and, you know, kind of build this friendship, and then all of a sudden, I kind of start getting like more presence in FetLife, on FetLife. And I was starting to get requests of like submissive people who wanted to pay me to do dominant stuff. So I kind of just started that way, and then one day I was just incredibly bored and felt stuck, you know, in my job. I was like head of marketing at a really nice company. I was very comfortable. It was great. I was not happy, you know.
I'm sorry.
So one day I said, I quit the shit and I opened my own dungeon. You know?
Yeah. And you knew right away. You knew what to do. You knew how to do it.
I did not.
Oh, so you're like, we're just gonna tie these fuckers up.
Not like that. But I will.
Interject. Tell us the truth. Come on. Yeah.
No, I don't know anything. Too like this.
Yeah, she doesn't know. I'm just right back.
I'm gonna put a blind in between. You do know. Yeah. The diary, Mistress Rogue, is the real diary.
So Mistress Mercy, I would always, because she's down in Fort Lauderdale and I was up here in Tampa, so I would always ask her questions, you know, how do I do this, how do I do that, and she will always be there for me. So like, she is key in my success, I want to say. Yeah, I owe her a lot. Yeah, we're best friends.
You guys are still friends.
Oh, absolutely. We talk every week.
Love that.
She's got married.
To a man.
Yeah. Her son.
Oh, I thought you said her son. I'm like, wait.
No! Oh my god.
Like, I don't think you can say that on
yours.
I don't know the rest of
it. So, I started just doing dominatrix work and it kind of just.
Do you guys ever do like a tag team? Yes, we do.
Actually, in my dungeon, I am the headmistress of a house.
Your dungeon right here.
Yes, we are in the dungeon. This is a dumb house. So in the dumb house, I work with other girls. Friends. Some others are just not as close, but more like a working relationship. So we work together. They don't work for me. I'm not like their owner or anything.
Just
like work together.
Just have the one.
Which is not a dumb, but you know.
Can I just point it out? They have Venezuelan, a Caucasian. May I just say that? Ever role play?
Yeah.
Do you guys know how awesome it is? We've never done that role play, but that's just, I just have to be that girl.
Yeah.
I was like, can I point out the race one?
My other son is my boyfriend. It's my nephew part of my
life. I'm sorry, you have a boyfriend.
Yeah. Oh, it's hard. I told him we're poly.
Okay, when you said that, I heard it.
So it's three of us in the house.
Okay, alright.
We have a 3-bedroom apartment.
Okay.
I sleep with my boyfriend.
Okay.
And then she has her room.
A true male.
A true male.
You
American.
There are no dicks. Like, really?
Yeah, I don't have any dicks.
What? Wait. Okay, so is there any inner... Are you part of that? There's the three...
No.
Okay.
So there's no intercourse between us. Just my boyfriend. Jesus.
Wait, no. No intercourse between you and Danielle.
Unless it's like... Careful.
Unless I'm bottoming.
Yeah, she's my bottom.
Play that.
It means I fucked her with a strap.
Okay.
Yeah,
in the ass,
obviously,
right?
Yeah.
Well, the mouth too, right?
Yeah.
Okay,
I'm not going to do that.
very much like you would love to think when well, things are company, but now we're
yeah. She also works with me.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, okay. All right. So, okay.
It's like a network.
I was a network of people.
Yeah.
Network
of
people. Yes. I'm just trying to see the flow of her.
Gone an hour because I'm so fascinated. I just don't even. This is, we are
are definitely right. doing part two because Absolutely. Everybody needs to know this. Right. This is the most phenomenal thing ever, and maybe it's just me, but I, again, love that question. Yeah. I'm always down.
Absolutely.
And you two, I am friends forever. I love it. I think that's you guys, we have to do something together. We have to collab.
Oh, body. Yeah. Absolutely.
We have to do a chip and
spell. We have this thing we want to do. I am very busy,
yeah.
But in the back of my head, I have this project. We want to do performances.
Okay.
We want to do shows and stuff. We just haven't really found the time to perform, to rehearse and stuff like that, or create a show or something. But we do want to do that.
Okay. I think this would be amazing because I travel to shows, so maybe we travel and do some shows, even if it's just once or twice, to just get it out there. Because I'm telling you. I love you guys, and we are coming back for part two because I'm going to force both of you guys to do something.
Absolutely.
I would love that.
I would
love
like
that.
To see it
try. I would beat the shit out of her right by your photo off.
Oh, God.
I joke into me. I don't even know if she'll let me out.
Yeah, you don't know.
Tell us again, where to meet Ms. Rishrobe. How would we book her? Twitter?
Ms. Rishrobe. Ms. Rishrobe, Florida.
And FL. And does she have Facebook?
Yeah, Ms. Rishrobe.
Mr. Shrug all around, and
just Mr. Shrug and Google. That's all you need to do.
I love that she's the only one that'll come right up. I love it. Oh, one more thing. Are you hated by all the other mistresses?
Yes, I am hated by a couple of local mistresses. It's ridiculous. Please stop.
You know why you're lying? You can't be. You didn't have the haters. You
wouldn't know what our. I agree. I like to be friends with everybody, but sometimes drama is over
the wall. The more haters, the more haters you are. Obviously, you're doing something great. I'm gonna hate you right now. Yeah, now you haters, so.
Nope.
I might have did my mouth.
Your mouth
was. Come on, Lane. Like, tell us. I feel like you hated it.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I do have to say, Dominatrix is being very catty, and it sucks, because I'd rather be friends with everybody.
Yes, I'm out there, punishing people who probably aren't going to be friends.
You know, you put a bunch of tigers in the room,
yes.
They're not going to,
No one's going to eat vaginas that are going to, scratch.
They're going to try to boss each other out.
That happens. See, I'm not a mistress anymore. Now mistress.
Unless you want haters.
I love
people. Like, everyone has haters, you know?
I have a lot of haters right now. They think I had all this work done, and I'm like, it's natural. Yeah, my eyebrows are tattooed, whatever. I'm gonna get some Dermafill, but everything else is no problem.
Fuck them.
Okay.
Let them hate.
Yeah, see, I told you, see? I'm gonna get you shirts and stuff then.
Call me when you get more followers. I don't know.
I love it. Thank you so much for giving me your time, because I didn't pay for it.
It's okay. I wouldn't charge you.
Oh, yeah.
I don't charge pretty girls.
Thank God. God, I got extra, and I paid for you. Get my hair. I'll tell you, I never do my hair. So we are here also with the famous Gary Patel, who's in here taking some awesome pictures.
He's fucking incredible. Please.
Incredible. He
so
is
good.
Out
please
here.
Look him up, because
taking amazing pictures of my sister, aka Harmony, Geneva D. She's on YouTube, and Hourglass Body, that's Body with an I. And right now, she is taking phenomenal pictures. I wish I could turn around, but I cannot. Oh, I can see her in there. Oh, cool. I didn't have to turn
around. Oh, yeah, you guys have been getting all this show.
Yes, we've been getting the whole show. So we're here with Tokyo Ish, and I'm sponsored by Manscaped, and I want everybody to tune in. We're everywhere. Spotify, Amazon, iTunes, iHeartRadio, anywhere you can get your podcast. Come and listen to my girls.
Awesome.
Hey. Ooh, that was an hour. I couldn't take it. I was like, that's an hour. I gotta go. We're going far.
Yeah, we did.
So what we'll do is we'll cut it up into two. And then it'll be like two episodes. It'll be like maybe 30 some minutes each for one whole week is yours.
Okay.
So what I'm doing is, if you guys can get 3,000 people to listen to it, because it's tracked on my thing, I will give you $500.
Oh my God, really?
5,000 people, I will give you $1,000.
How would you know?
It's tracked. It's tracked on your episode. If people download your episode, all I saw was tits. Do you see them? I was covering them because my YouTube. Oh, too late. You're gonna get kicked off.
Man, that was very much fun.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Why could I stop laughing? I'm listening to you. Are you laughing? She is. Yeah. And I had the Down syndrome mouth.
Oh God.
Carrie, did you tell me you were constipated? Yeah. Like, what is that? I said, like, you know what somebody looks got. I love it. I see things still different.
I don't look at myself when I'm constipated.
He goes, oh, he's like, oh, I got the constipated look. It's right here. This is it.
I'm like, is this what you call it?
Thank you so much. Oh my God, that was great. Yeah, it was going to split us up, but I'm like, we did good as
two. So you
two.
Have everything?
Yeah, I did.
That was cool.
I'm like, it's simple and easy. I did.
Yeah.
I'm like, you can come out here and talk as much as you want anytime, because I don't
mind. When do you think they'll be up?
give me a couple weeks just because I had to edit this.
Oh, absolutely.
And there's some archived already that I'm still letting out from the board.
Nice.
Some after hours that we're like, yeah, awesome. But definitely that we can get ready. I'll let you know before.
Please let me know the YouTube
video. I definitely want. Oh yeah, hers evolved way before mine. Hers evolved in a week or so, and listen, we're friends for life. Friends for life. I'm a type of person. Unless you tell me to fuck off, I'm not going anywhere.
I'm back.
Definitely, but I love it.
And do you want to take a picture together?
I do, yeah, definitely. Yeah. Let me get my slut clothes on.
Okay,
slut clothes.
Yeah.
Well, when I'm, are you done?
Well, it was with mine.
Oh, okay. Oh, you ready for me, Carrie?
I'm done with her.
She's okay. Doing her butt ass naked. Ooh. And showing.
If Carrie can face down. Oh God, yeah. Sure, that would look nice.
Yeah, I wish I would have known when I was so pregnant and taken. I've always wanted to do those pregnancy photos.
Oh.
I've never known.
I'm going to do this right here. Let me close this out. I'm going to change my outfit and then we'll take pictures. I definitely want us to take pictures together.
So can you explain to me the cold thingy here?
What cold thing?
It's just a mattress, right?
It's like crazy.
Waterproof.
Oh God.
Mattress.
Oh yeah, we just got that like a few days ago.
All right. Like, if you're a person that that's the best. Pete, should I put on what? What do you make?
Okay. You're already in it, so.
Yeah.
I mean, I was gonna put on your thigh high boots.
Okay.
And I was gonna put on my. Would it be funny if I put on my butt shirt and just wear my cute little panties?
No.
That'd be cute.
That would be cute. All
right.
What butt shirt?
It's in the hair. I have to talk your instrument, but I don't know. I don't know if it's like up to par. I have some other.
You don't want to wear your pajama jeans.
You know what? Sure, I am. All right. I got some fat to hide, so. Do you want to look in there really quick and see? I want to take some of my regular shirts and say, you know, I can't grab stuff. Oh, yeah. What are you saying? You don't want no leopard?
You can.
Your shoes, I'm talking for the podcast. Alright, let me just do this with your boots first.
Okay,
right, I'll just, so, you guys are okay with me taking the pictures? Okay. I want to be taking up all your time. Alright, I'm gonna do this with the black boots first.
Okay.
Keep this aside. Let me go potty real quick and then I'll just put this on.
Your
favorite. Okay.
Oh, that's fun.
Oh, I'm so happy you guys had fun. I want it to be fun. Is it, was it different than what you thought?
It wasn't more professional than I thought.
Okay.
Yeah,
I
thought it was
just
gonna be us with a phone.
No, I'm like, oh no. I'm like, girl, we got set up.
Yeah.
Yes.
I really love that I can hear myself.
Yeah, oh yeah, that's actually pretty cool.
Yeah, that's what you need with the noise canceling headset. Like that's definitely what is needed.
Oh,
it's
the next bathroom.
See, I don't even remember hearing myself, but every time you get me on there, I can just break it.
Yeah, I
can
replace it.
Did you
have
my time?
Oh, yeah. Here, let me get it. I'll get this out of the way. I don't care if the door closes. You guys don't mind hearing me tinkle.
Try not to stomp too much in that area.
Yeah.
It's like a, there's like a weird spacing under the floor, so if you want to walk around, try not to go too crazy over there.
Yeah.
And it's like midnight. Yeah. Oh, they're going to hate this. I mean, it's fucking Friday. Who cares?
I know, but they told us that
she did say she works at night, so it doesn't matter.
You know what's funny? She's like, well, let Candy come friend. Yeah, obviously that car.
Like, she has a wheelchair.
Oh my God.
I'm so sorry. Yeah. Girl, and yeah. Send a picture.
Send a picture.
Yeah, I'll come to give
her. Here, we'll put you on the floor like you fell.
Give him my daughter. I'll take care of it. Yeah, what? Here, you need my help?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so
Do you want to stop it?
Yeah, we can stop it. We've been recording for a while.
Yeah.
I just creep in there smiling. I know, I'm so weird.